more seconds.
Yes. Same time, we can just take one wine before that. Okay. Check one, two. So we are live now. We are live from Tallinn, Estonia, from Lift 99 Hub here. Because today, after 100 hours non-stop hacking, speaking with mentors, changing things every after, like, you know, our Salto Camp 4 is ready to kick off our live presentations. The good news is that, you know, it was so intensive that, that maybe the best way how to show this is that I think that there was a Martin who made amazing, like, you know, photos about it. How difficult is basically to attend in the Salto Camp? So maybe have these slides now up. Yes. First of all, like, we need to tell, like, before we're starting, that this event is here because Estonian government, Estonian Development Corporation, Startup Estonia, has been really thinking how Estonia could help Georgia. And originally, yes, we planned to have this event physically in Georgia, but as we know, you know, flying around is already yesterday. In the nowadays, you do everything online. So we switched this camp into the fully online mode, which was pretty intensive from our side, because in these last 4 months, what happened, that some of the teams has been growing, but some of the teams has been also like faced so difficult times that literally before camp, some startups said that we can't just attend. But if you're asking how difficult is Startup Camp, here is the slide what you need to know. This is the great example how people felt yesterday. This was the day yesterday. And the example is, as Wendel said, let's give now, it's so intensive that one of the founders and CEOs didn't have any time. So Martin, you found the only time where to go haircut right now. Why you need haircut, by the way, Martin? Can you give us a comment?
Yeah, because I didn't have time to even get out of the house during that time. So I'm going to participate on the investors festival, one of the biggest investors festival in Estonia. And just didn't want to look like a bear.
Come on. I think that looking is a very good thing. I think that two polished people, like two, like, you know, like nice looking people have never received money. So maybe it's a wrong move.
But, no.
But amazing. So thank you for this. I think that this is the most legendary, like, you know, which literally tells how intensive is our camp. But okay. Enough talk now, because I think that what everybody now is super excited is about these 13 companies. But one more time, let's repeat what we have gone through and what is this. Salto Camp is literally 100 hours, super intensive accelerator to basically push you into the next level, depending where you are now. It can be, it's super personal, depending, do you want to grow? You want to go to the new markets and all of those things. And also, why we are doing it? Because we have been collecting together one of the best mentors globally. Like, exactly, we have been building the new platform, which will be fully live after like months. The idea is that there are always some crazily good people in Estonia, Ukraine, name it, in other countries, but how we can build bigger communities that, you know, right startup talent can go and help startup from any country, anywhere. Because there is one way is to just go to Silicon Valley, but we can't do it now. We have to be ready to find these people who help us no matter where we are. And this is exactly what Salto is doing, to connecting promising startup with amazing talent. And this, one of the activities is Salto Camp. But okay, I think that, you know, enough talk. It's not about me. It's about these amazing startups, 13 of them, who has been working heavily. And, you know, as an example, before this live, I just talked with one mentor, Martin Henk, and he said that he was super like tired after one day of mentoring. But this startups has been going, so that now this is the fifth day. And he said he was so tired that he was, I don't know how you can do that. I was so tired after one day, but you are just running this as a, like, you know, sprint, like in 5 days and so on. So that shows something. And, you know, indeed, Martin Henk was helping startups, but also made some very big, like, promises, not promises, decisions. But this is what we hear soon. But first, let's go to the pitching. And the first company, which will be up now, and they are showing, first of all, what they are building, but what DJ achieved in this 100 hours is a good Perry. Please, stage is yours.
Hi everyone, we are Codeberry and we are building the largest online coding school in the world. The problem is that the world needs 2 million developers, but learning to code is hard, especially so if you have to do it in another language than your own, for example English. And this is where Codeberry comes in. We are a fully localized, gamified online programming school for non-English speakers. Let me show you a quick demo. So we have everything in English, Hungarian, Romanian, Polish, Vietnamese. We teach you how to code. You can try it in the browser. You can write your code on the left and run it on the right. And we support you on Slack. There is a vibrant student community and mentors who help you along the way. Our key numbers are 1.4k paying students, 29k MRR, 30 euros customer acquisition cost, and 100 euros of lifetime value. We are 10 full-time and 44 part-time team members from 17 countries. We have three investors who invested 1.5 million euros so far. Okay, now let's see the five projects that we have been working on the last 100 hours. We want to go to new markets, so we increased the number of available languages from 8 to 20. The ads are starting today. Based on Pavel's advice, we tried to speed up the website. We moved everything to CloudFront, but sadly everything got a bit slower, so this experiment failed. Based on Pavel's advice, we tried out if we should go to cities instead of countries first. We checked if this hypothesis matches our data, we visualized it, and we realized it's not, so we are not going to do that. Based on the remote management roundtable, we decided to ditch our current password manager and try out a new one. And we have a great talk with the PizData guys as they run an online programming school before we decided to buy their curriculum. And in the mentoring sessions, master classes and roundtables, we made notes, 55 pages overall. Okay, so how can you help? Currently, we are looking for English-speaking teachers who love coding and are not afraid to teach online. If you know anyone, please contact us. Thanks for everything. It was a lovely week.
Thank you, Codeberry. It seems that that Pavel was giving you really bad advice because you tried out and you know nothing was as you expected. But let me ask this first of all: that you are launching now 12 different languages. So, what is your feeling out of this? What is the three most promising? Have you already run the advertising, and so on? Please.
I think data will show. So what we usually do is that we always have hopes for it would be really nice to have Indonesia running or Vietnam or whatever. And then the numbers are always different than what we hope. So overall, I would say that let it give a bit of time and the data will show.
Okay. And the second question that I had, like giving facts that most of the world was locked down. What was the effect of this lockdown for the Codeberry? Did you see any changes in the traction, in the KPIs and so on in the last 3-4 months?
Yes. Overall, what we saw is that more people were at home sitting next to their computer. So our overall customer acquisition costs went down. And now as the lockdown is over in the Central European region, we see that customer acquisition cost is climbing back again. So I probably cannot really say that we are hoping for the second wave of the virus, but it's really interesting that a global situation can definitely change the business numbers that we have.
Awesome. And the last question before we jump into the next startup. So you have Slack group, as I saw, with 11,000 members. How active is this community, what you have built?
It's different from country to country. So our Hungarian Slack is the largest. And we have a really vibrant community. So many people asking questions, helping each other with jobs and stuff like that. It's really different on, it also have a cultural aspect. So for example, Mexican people, only three of them signed up and they already were talking. In the Polish market, we had more than 1,000 people and we were just trying to make, yeah, let's ask daily questions so people start to respond. So it's also a cultural thing.
Awesome. Thank you, Goodberry. Thank you, Hungary. Really nice start of the event. Thank you.
Thank you, thank you.
And the first of all, good news is that Martin haircut is done. Now he's driving to the office. So we have live coverage. So Martin was in the haircut today. Check mark. Yes, this is Martin driving. Thank you. I hope that you will go and wash some car now. I hope so. But before we will see that one, next company up is from Ukraine. So let's see what is Bistata. Stage is yours. Go.
Hi there, we are Roman and Stacy, founders of Bizdata. From Ukrainian, Bizdata means fucking amazing.
Bizdata is a web app to get design tasks done in 24 hours. We prove that getting design done can be dramatically easier and up to 10 times cheaper. Remember posting this Recommend Me a Designer thing, reaching out to freelancers, checking their portfolios, dealing with hourly payouts. Now you can forget. With Bizdata, you have one subscription to cover all common design areas from branding to UI whenever the new task comes in. Basically, today you submit a task, tomorrow you get it done. Bizdata is a web app with a flat monthly fee, and when you create the new task, it's matched with relevant and available designer on the platform and delivered on the next business day. It works kind of like sharing economy for a creative profession of design. We automate marketing design routine for agencies, funds, and startups of all sizes, including Y Combinator alumni and startup industry leaders like PeopleAI, Restream, Very Good Security. Bizdata is 1 year old and it bootstrapped with 25K of our own savings. Along the way, we had 70 plus paid clients on the platform and 600 plus design tasks done. Our traction, Bizdata is profitable and growing with the latest revenue of 11K. Salto Growth Camp results. We accomplished several goals. The first one, we finally pushed the rebranding, which means transition to the new domain, new website design, and updated pricing model. Goal number two, new angel aboard. We're happy to welcome Martin Hank, co-founder of Pipedrive, with very relevant product expertise. We are also now closing the first pre-seed round for 100K with legendary angels such as Mikko Silventola, the first angel of Bolt, and Bas Gotska, number one Dutch angel due to Crunchbase. Goal number three, we crash-tested and adjusted our growth and marketing strategy with the mentors, as we're about to hire 7 new people next month. Who has done all of this magic? Here we are and our amazing team. Long story short, once, 5 years ago, young full-stack developer and a digital marketer met on Tinder, and since then, our founder path started. We are Roman and Stacy, founder of Bizdata, which is now becoming Asomic. Awesome on a cosmic level. We have one slot left for amazing angel to join, so feel free to reach us out. Thank you for your attention. Asomic. Awesome on a cosmic level.
Okay, that was a good one. And frankly, I do know almost you, I think that close to 2 years, but this is the first time you tell publicly that you met each other in Tinder. That's a very, very interesting startup story, first of all. But second, Roman, like you started that this brand is amazing. Why the hell you changed so amazing brand?
Oh, yeah, because a Bizdata is like our internal joke, which people from Ukraine, Russia understand, who know what's the meaning. But our target audience from Europe and US, they mostly don't understand. They're thinking we do something with pizza and data, so it's not our case. And we change it to Asomic, which actually same meaning what is Bizdata, but in English. And also it have meaning with Cosmos, and we love Cosmos, so it's, yeah.
That's a reason.
Okay. The next question, if I was looking at your progress slide, is that you're telling that you change something, it's pricing. Can you a little bit be more specific? What exactly to change in the pricing?
Yeah, I can tell that. Now we have two plans, which is divided more like features or use cases. One is graphic design, second is UI design. But basically it was wrong because UI design plan now already includes everything, including graphic and animation. And like we decided after the masterclass of Mielis that our users are not complaining about the price, they're happy to buy. So we need to raise the price. That's why we're updating the pricing model. And now we will have at least three main plans: graphic design, UI design separately, and all-in-one plan to include this one subscription for every design area. And we're also adding add-ons for like UX design, illustration. So basically, yeah, we're updating the whole model.
Okay, I would really love to one day like speak with the designers who are part of the community. But last question was like, when we talked with mentors, that some of them mentioned that they have been using like 99design. So how you are different and how you can get like people who has been using 99design using your product?
Who goes?
You go.
Okay, so the main difference that on 99designer, you need to post a project, you need to receive portfolios from designers, their work, you need to choose, pick it, then you need to talk with them about a price, that's it. So our main difference is you don't need to spend time on finding a right freelancer, reviewing them, interviewing, doing HR and so on.
So basically, we believe that we're solving different problems. 99design and Upworks and things like that, they're solving the problem of getting design done. You have a task and you're like struggling and having all the progress to get to this result. And we are matching you, and magic is in the matching you with the right expert on the platform and getting result on the next business day. You are not like involved in any kind of process behind, you just need the result done and it's here for you.
So I don't know how much Red Bull or what did you like was drinking before this live, but definitely you have huge energy. Thank you, Roman and Stacy. Amazing. Thank you.
Thank you too.
And now we are jumping to Estonia, because next startup is a guy who I think said told in our CEO updates most likely the most impressive story about how difficult is actually start a founder's life and how you sometimes have to fight with, I don't even know, like it's just amazingly negative press. The next is Hugo Liigal from Estonia. Tallinn, please.
Üks, kaks.
Elar, we have problems. There is no audio. Can we just restart this?
Yeah, give me a second.
That's the beauty of the live demos. So it's something always be could happen. But luckily, okay, we are just dealing it in any second. And you know, exactly. Okay. So let's try on more time.
So let's see.
I still think that we don't have audio.
Okay, that's interesting. Let me see. Maybe I can.
So we are just testing out. The good news is that we have actually the founder is next to me. So we super need that. We can just give microphone to him and he can do the audio, which would be like MC, you know. But let's first try out different things. I think we have never had this kind of case, but you know, that's the beauty of the technical stuff in the world. You never know what kind of like, you know, format is working and whatnot. But let's see first. As soon as you are ready, just hit.
One more time.
Yes, one more time. Otherwise, we just do hear audio.
Each and every one of us has at least one friend who can't afford legal services due to the high price. And therefore, their rights are not protected enough. We can help them, all of them, Good day. My name is Arthur, and I'm the founder and CEO of Hugo Legal, a SaaS-enabled marketplace of lawyers and lawbots. The legal industry is huge and it's growing, but the delivery of legal services has been quite the same over the past centuries. This is one of the reasons why most people can't afford traditional law firms. And yet, there are a great number of highly qualified lawyers on the market, but they're not efficient enough at acquiring new customers, dealing with downtime at marketing, PR, billing, customer support, and so forth. Hugo integrated all the infrastructure a lawyer needs with the matchmaking marketplace to provide an end-to-end system for solo practitioners, freelance lawyers, and law boutiques. With Hugo, lawyers can concentrate only on the very essence of their work, and they can do that at a time and manner that they prefer and in the legal field that they choose. Hugo connects consumers, small and medium-sized businesses with the right legal expert at the right time and cost in the corresponding jurisdiction. We bill lawyers according to their revenue with management fee. So far, we have successfully matched over 30,000 clients with lawyers, making us the largest legal service platform in Estonia. Our last year's GMV was 1 million euros in total, and over the coming years, we're planning to triple it annually. Hugo's founders have profound experience in business, in technology, in marketing, and in legal for more than 10 years. And we have an amazing team, consists of 12 members in 4 different nationalities, all fully committed to revolutionize the legal industry. Our long-term vision is to build a universal robot lawyer, so that most common cases could be solved by a robot lawyer, and more complex ones would be matched to the real lawyer by AI. We have built robot lawyers in Estonia and in Poland. These robots have been very successful on generating leads on the marketplace. In addition, thousands of clients have saved 500,000 euros in total without any human intervention. What took us several weeks to develop takes now 3 days. During the past 100 hours at Salto Camp, we developed Lawbot as a service product so we could launch a new Lawbot at a much faster pace. And we have already. As of today, we launched a new Lawbot in Estonia to protect the rights of many employees at these difficult times. We also made 1 minute law video for content marketing reasons, started running ads, and got mainstream media coverage. We're on a mission to make access to justice possible. For the expansion to new EU markets, we're raising 1 million euros as a seed investment. My name is Arthur, and we are Hugo Legal. Thank you.
Wow, that was like really cool, like, you know, video production. I don't know, you used some TV, maybe used the same TV guys who did this video about you in the back in days in Canal 2, like Kuuuuri. Did you use them to doing that video?
No, our CMO has actually, she's been in the movie industry in Estonia for more than 15 years. So it's all thanks to Aga and her experience and editing and such.
Yeah, I think it was an amazing video. It's just, you know, great story and so on. But the one thing about the business side, I want to ask that. So, okay, so you entered to Poland, like, I think that it was more than like 7-8 months ago. Share us, what has been your learnings in this new market, Poland, super big? What has been Hugo Legal biggest learning from entering to Poland so far?
Well, I think one of the most important things that we learned were that we were very optimistic that we just go there, we just launch the marketplace, we make money like we make here, and then go to new market, go to Spain, and then do this exact same thing. And, you know, Poland for us was, you know, the first market abroad, and it's kind of like a first intercourse. It's, you're excited to do that, but actually don't know what to do. So I think over the past 6 months we just learned how to, you know, go to new markets and to have a concrete go-to-market strategy, because we had some, but it was a vague one. And so I think we learned how to do it much better, much faster. And one thing that I recommend to every startup to go abroad, there needs to be some kind of like these clear goals that you want to achieve this within 3 months or something. Our goal was, we want to go to Poland and we want to make money. So that was like not very clear. So there need to be clear goals. And I think we learned a lot of and we'll make a comeback to Poland quite soon.
But okay, you tested out Poland, you have some learnings for them. So what is the next geographical like markets you are now looking to expand, and when you would feel that could happen?
Well, I think the this year's focus will be in EU, but after a year or so, we do want to go to explore opportunities in Africa or even Latin America. We have considered Singapore, Asia as well. So we want to go to explore other continents, but right now the focus will be EU. And since we have now this Lobot as a service product, it needs still some bug fixes and design and such. But with this product, we can go to new markets in a much faster pace than ever before. And we can just test it out, see whether we fit in that country or not. This year will be EU focus and mainly Poland and Spain.
Great. Thank you for that.
And one thing that you can see us Monday, probably either Monday or Tuesday on Reporter. So there's going to be a news about that. Yeah.
So this similar like was in Kuuria or different?
No. It's going to be a positive one.
Okay. Thank you, Artur. Thank you so much. We have a live people actually walking in, walking out, you know. But now, let's now jump back to the Ukraine, because the next company is a smart sender. But make this super unique and amazing that they have been bootstrapping so far. Let's say, what is smart sender about and what did she achieve in last 100 hours? Please, smart sender.
Hi, everybody. My name is Aik and I'm the founder of smart sender. Usually it takes an hour to explain what we built at smart sender. We see ourselves as a matrix hackers, but other things that we're just weird nerds. Let's change things. This is Joshua. Joshua is a startup founder with very promising product. Joshua's startup is an online dating service with a fast-growing customer base. The startup uses MailChimp to engage and retain customers. When the customer base reaches the 50,000 threshold, Joshua decides to start sending messages via a more scalable and affordable email service. Joshua decides to build an in-house notification service and hire a developer. After some research, Joshua decides to go forward with SendGrid as an email API. Fast, reliable, scalable, not so expensive. To analyze customers' behavior, Joshua integrates Google Analytics, but shortly understands that different users interact with his product in different ways. Joshua decides to segment the audience. Joshua starts integration with segmentation tools, and as the system is very complex, Joshua hires another developer to maintain it. Joshua adds Twilio to send SMS, Zapier to synchronize the customer data. He integrates OneSignal to send push notifications and adds Amazon Web Services to store the event data. Another developer and a DevOps engineer to support the system, a quality assurance engineer, a product manager. Success. Not so much. Joshua created a monster which loves money and has nothing to do with an online dating startup he worked on. Somebody needs to stop the monster. And the smart sender is here to take the lead. Scalable email infrastructure, SMS and push notifications, advanced customer analytics, reasonable pricing, and fanatical support in one package. Right now, we send 50 million messages per month, and the platform can handle over 1 billion messages right now. 50,000 monthly recurring revenue, and average 53% year-over-year revenue growth without a single cent of outside investment, and we definitely have a positive trend. Saltalk Growth Camp was quite productive for us. Over 16 one-on-one calls with mentors. We fully reforged our sales flow. Over 500 cold outreach messengers, 4 demos, 2 closed deals, 1 storyline-based presentation, a lot of hate towards our landing page. We need 10 million euros to become a unicorn company. Intro to large brands and strategic partners, your boots and motorcycle. If you want more details, let's have a coffee. Thank you.
Wow, thank you. It really seems that the fact that your daughter found some monsters in on the overnight was really inspiring for you. So I think that what I really love about that in this presentation, I think that you finally nailed down what you're building. Because every single person should now understand this thing, what you're building is just making this complexity using like 7, 8, 7, 6 into the one thing. Amazing. But my question is, looking at your progress, what you have made in 100 hours, can you a little bit open up what exactly did you change in the change flow now after these 100 hours?
Before this camp, we know that we need to do something, and we try to do something. Now we have a structured process which can be, which have steps. We can experiment. We know what we need to do on each step, what kind of metrics we need to check, and how we need to optimize each step to have better and better results and all the time. So we have the process, we need to tune it, and we'll be ready to scale the whole process by hiring people and putting more fire by digital advertisement and marketing technologies.
Okay, and tell us, you are telling in your progress that you closed two deals. What kind of companies you got in this week? So example.
One company, which is the bigger one, is a security application, mobile application, which provides some security and parental control things. And they have over 3 million emails monthly. And they are pretty fast growers. And the second one is... how to explain it? They provide software as a service solution, and they have around 2,000 registrations per month new. So they need to automate all the things, and we'll help with them with onboarding, automation of customer retention, and analytics related to it.
Got it. But last question, I'm just calculating. I think that you have been growing way more than 50% annually, because you had in December, your revenue was in range of 30,000. Now it's 50. So in the last 6 months, you have been growing approximately 50%.
It's average year over year. We just took all this period. Last 3-4 months were very interesting, because we just boost for 30% only during one first quarter when the COVID crisis started, when the customers started to enlarge their online communication, and the users also started to spend much more time on online services, and all the related communication just boost our numbers for additional 30% only during first quarter.
Exactly. So I think that you have amazing product, but definitely, like, many mentors mentioned that as well, that they would love to help you in the future as well, that to basically show how much good things you have built already and how much is your opportunity. But thank you anyway. Thank you, Hayak. And now, super special, because now we jump into the Africa. The next team is from Nigeria, and in many, many ways, it has been super inspiring for all of the people in the camp, the other teams, because many times people don't realize how big opportunity lays down in Africa. And, you know, even exactly just a few minutes ago, Hugo mentions that they are even considering now to expand it to Africa. I believe this is also because we have Printivo, who has been super actively not only pushing himself but helping other teams. But first, let's see, what is Printivo about and what did you achieve? Please.
Hi, my name is Oluyonyojo, and I'm the CEO of Printivo.com. Printivo is an e-commerce site empowering small businesses across Africa to create marketing collateral using the power of the internet and have it delivered to their doorsteps. Our customers create products like business cards, letterhead, flyers, posters, mugs, everything that they need to market their brands offline. How does it work? Customers simply visit our website. They can easily pick a template and design their artwork on our site. And once they are done, they make payment with their credit card. And Printivo will print the item, whether it's business card, letterhead, flyers, or whatever. We print the item and deliver it to their doorstep within 3 days. Finally, we are helping our customers stop the multiple visits to print shops. Over the years, we have active customers of 5,300, and in addition, to these customers, brands like Bolt, Google, Microsoft, BBC, and other big brands uses our online print services. We launched in 2014, and to date, we've made $2.8 million in revenue. Last year, we made revenue of $850,000. It cost us averagely $12,000 to acquire a customer whose AOV is $120 and lifetime value of $167.58. In the last 24 hours, we've launched a new segment in our business in micro packaging for food and small and e-commerce businesses. This has expanded our SKUs by over 30% and we will keep expanding. To launch this, we signed a partner print company that will handle the manufacturing side of the business. In addition, we've built an expansion plan into 4 African markets with data-driven decision-making on how to expand and where to expand to. On top of that, we signed partnership with 3 printing companies whose job is to be as part of our print marketplace to support and print items for our customers. Our new model is to actually outsource printing to a marketplace of printing companies across Africa. So Printivo customers order on the front end, and then the print companies fulfill the items for our customers. Our team is made up of really, really smart people. Myself, Ibukunlo Yede, Julie Abayomi, who is our CTO, and Temitope Kundayo, who is head of growth. We are working to raise $1 million to fund our Pan-African growth. And we believe that there are investors here who want to up and join us on this journey. Thank you, and let's do this.
Let's do this, definitely. Let's do this, Nigeria. I have done many hackathons in my life, in like back from 2010 when we started Garage 48. But I think that one of the most biggest energy I ever saw was in Nigeria in 2011 in Lagos. But now, Printivo, tell us, why did you pick micro packing, and how many deals did you already have closed? How many companies have you managed to close that say want to actually order this micro packaging?
When the COVID-19 pandemic started, we experienced a very huge decline in our sales, and we realized that several small businesses and restaurants and the rest, we used to like do where customers to come in to eat and everything, started doing delivery, and everybody started moving online. So we lost sales coming from event conferences, printing for event conferences and the rest. But we started seeing a lot of inquiries coming in the side of, I want to make boxes, I want to make delivery packages, I want to make this. And this is what led to us going to that direction. So we just launched this product now, and we've received some orders from that.
Awesome. And the next thing, you showed that you want to expand to the 3 new countries. Will be the like priority or focus out of these 3 countries, and how did you make this priority?
Okay, so the first thing we did was currently we keep having customers who visit the website and chat, because we have a live chat feature on the website, and they literally chat with the team to say, oh, do you ship to Kenya? Do you have operations in South Africa? And in the past, we've actually tested those markets and shipped to those markets. Also, in addition, what we've done is to look at the markets that are English-speaking countries, so that there is no language barrier, economies that are stable with big GDP and have very strong entrepreneurial activities. And in addition, we looked at markets that have some existing competition going on. Yeah.
Awesome. Thank you, Oyomi. I think that it has been really, really amazing you being part of, and your team, part of the camp, because we really hope that you will be someone who will help heavily to take this thing what we have been giving you in this 1 week and help to build much stronger sort of community, not only in Nigeria, but overall in Africa. Thank you, Oyomi. It has been really amazing to have you in the camp.
Yeah.
And now we jump into the back to Estonia, and we go into our like famous resort Pärnu, which, you know, is a small city in Estonia. I think it's around 40,000 people, but Team Webergs has a real, not a dream even now, but promise to put Pärnu also into the global map where startups are coming. Let's see what is Webergs about. Please, Webergs. Webergs.
Hi, my name is Oliver and I'm the CEO and co-founder of Webergs. Nowadays, websites are built like a Lego. Open source and third-party code makes web developers more efficient and saves companies a lot of development hours. In fact, 85% of the code in an average web application comes from third-party components. Unfortunately, with the popularity comes unwanted attention. A single popular component can often be installed to millions of websites. Hackers now need to find just one vulnerability to target millions of sites at once. Since the attacks are automated, victims are not chosen. WebArchs allows web developers to benefit from third-party and open source code while staying protected. Developers can detect all third-party code they use, pinpoint the security risk, and block threats in real time. Our whole platform is powered by our very own bug bounty platform, where ethical hackers can submit new vulnerabilities and get paid in gamified environment. This gives WebArchs a clear competitive advantage over any existing solution on the market. Our security research and vulnerability research is also very well known. Many large tech news follow our blog and ask for our insights whenever a new threat arises. Within just 2 years after launch, over 4,000 developers from 80 plus countries trust WebArchs to protect more than 15,000 websites. This all is possible thanks to our amazing team. I personally started to look for a solution to this problem when I was running a web development company many years ago. Dave, our CTO, has done vulnerability research for more than 6 years, and Tauri joined us with his previous startup experience to bring clarity to numbers. Agnes is making sure WebArchs and our research gets to the right people. For majority of us, this is not our first company. As a business, we've had an amazing year. We have been growing our MRR for over 600%, and now in June, we did our new monthly revenue record. During the Salto Growth Camp, we really challenged our core messaging, and to keep up with the growth, we began hiring 4 more people. We really pushed the limits and finished a technical integration with a large, well-known international hosting company. If you're a badass developer or a conversion rate optimization pro, come and join us. My name is Oliver, this is WebArchs, and we protect websites from third-party code vulnerabilities. Thank you.
Wow, wow, wow. What a bold statement. 600% annually. That's a really huge one. But Oliver, hello to Pärnu first, but second of all, tell us what has been your company like life in last 3-4 months when the most of the world has been locked down. How and which way it had affected your KPIs, revenues, and so on?
Hey everyone. The last pretty much the whole beginning of the year was actually a real roller coaster. I would say the crisis kind of benefited for us because so many companies were losing their revenue from physical stores. They needed to jump into finding and keeping the revenue that they have on e-commerce. And of course, if more money moves to e-commerce, more attention and unwanted attention moves there as well. So what we saw really was really good growth, not just from revenue, but also from traffic, the attention that we got. And we even launched like this database where we actually collected information about the cyber threats that were using the COVID pandemic as something to leverage on. So this actually was really helpful for a lot of our customers and for the public as well. So this also generated a lot of traffic to us.
And another thing I wanted to ask, like you're mentioning, said you was going live with fund partnership. Can you give a sense how big this partnership and important is actually for your company?
I think it's pretty major. Definitely the biggest partnership we've ever had. They have around 29 million customers. So this probably gives you some sort of understanding of the size. But yeah, it will definitely change WebArcs over the next couple of months. So we're really excited to see and where it takes us.
Awesome. Thank you, Oliver. Thank you, Perno.
Thank you.
And now let me remind you, this camp started first thanks to Estonian government, thanks to Estonian community. We wanted to have this camp in Georgia. So this is why the next startup now is from Georgia, Irakli with the Go and Grow. Please, let's say what they are up to.
Hi, my name is Irakli Kashipadze. I'm a CEO and founder of Go and Grow. Go and Grow is a critical thinking development tool for kids. Unfortunately, schools are not developing real life skills. They are not preparing kids for their future challenges. Parents also don't have a time, but they would like to care about the kids. Kids don't like boring lessons without meanings and without game-based mechanics. We develop solution. It's a tool for critical thinking development based on AI. Our system is sending daily fun exercises to the email. Our AI personalizing content based on the level of critical thinking. And also we could provide to the parents and kids the level and progress of critical thinking. Our target market is schools from third grade till ninth grade. And also we could provide this to the corporate customers as a schools. The global market for this age of kids is 700 million people. Soft skills market, training market is growing, and for 2027, it will be $38 billion. We made quick launch at 1st of June and tested our hypothesis. We got very good feedbacks, and in 2 days registered 520 users. Currently, during 1 month, we have 38% of retention and 3% daily growth. Our business model is $9 per month with minimum registration for 3 months. We are expecting revenue for 2023 per year, $120 million. Our product, it's quizzes, games, and the kids are getting such kind of two exercises. It took only 10-15 minutes to make it. We are using micro-learning methodology. All process is based on game-based mechanics, and also we are providing leaderboard, we are measuring progress, and providing additional information. Our competitors are Brilliant.com, Luminosity, but they don't have direct orientation on soft skills. Our indirect competitors are Kahoot and Quizzes. Our competitive advantages is that we are using personalized content. We are using micro-learning, and each lesson took 10-15 minutes daily. And also we are science-based content and methodology. Our team programmer, Shota Eka, it's head of research team, content developer, Nino Anna. What we got from Growth Camp, Salto Growth Camp, it's first of all, improved storytelling on the website, created Go Global strategy, and also we formed better marketing strategy. What the next? We are starting paid service next week, and we are preparing to enter US market. Also, we are looking for EdTech mentors and looking for fundraising. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Irakli. You know, I was so ready to go to church. I had sunglasses, everything, you know, like, you know, I love, you know, the many things in Georgia, you know, like in Carlis, not sure about Sasha, by the way, but wine, Okay. The good news, by the way, is that Georgia is actually open for people from European Union. You can just fly in, whoo, and have a good vacation. But, Irakli, I have two questions for you. Let's start with that. I'm so surprised you're mentioning actually that you not only focusing like kids, but you actually see corporates as you're one of the potential clients. Can you a little bit open up what you mean corporate customers? How could corporate customers use your startup product?
First of all, thank you very much for inviting and choosing our startup for Salto Growth Camp. It was amazing and I liked it very much. It was great. What about corporates that, it might be schools, but also might be also big corporations. And we are planning to help also to grow employees' performance because they could solve better, they could solve problems better, they could analyze the current processes, see patterns, and etc. That's why, but we started from very small targeted market. We tested our hypothesis. We are a little bit younger than other startups and we are just on a beginning stage, but we see our potential not only providing ours by providing our service to kids, but also to other people because critical thinking and soft skills is very important for any people.
Awesome. And the last question that I have, you're telling that you changed your marketing strategy. Can you a little bit describe what exactly did you change?
Yeah. First of all, we had some decision to start growing globally a little bit later. But through meetings one-to-one with mentors, we decided to start testing more earlier, and we will start operation on the US market on the 1st of August. Also, we better understood the potential of conversion. With Pavel, we had very interesting discussions, and what will be potential expenditure, and of course, better storytelling, better messaging on the website, better also what we've got that to be not directly oriented on the parents, but also on the teachers. And teachers could provide us better results by advising our service to the kids. There is a lot of interesting things. We finally moved to the one domain, GoandGrowG, without kids.goandGrowG, also made some optimizations on the site. And more of them, it's a storytelling, better positioning of and target audience for our website and our service. But it was amazing experience. It's my first demo day. And I will learn more how to use such kind of opportunities in the future, of course. Thank you.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Thank you, Irakli. Thank you, Georgia. But it's not only sunny in Georgia, by the way. I believe that it's also sunny in Ukraine. So let's fly back to the Ukraine, and who else can bring us sun back is a big style. And Margaret, please.
Hi, I'm Margaret. I'm co-founder and CEO at Pix. We reinvent the ordinary by customizing everyday devices and accessories. Our mission is to entertain, engage, and overjoy people by providing exclusively creative products for everyday use. In our first product, we have combined hardware and software solutions and turned the usual backpack into the customizable digital device. We integrated the programmable LED screen into the urban backpack and led people to display any kind of pixel art right on their back. We also provide our users with the opportunity to engage with each other as well as create their own content and share it with the help of app built-in content marketplace. Our team is 12 full-time specialists in marketing, sales, manufacturing, as well as software and hardware engineers. In 2019, during our first year of operation, we have sold 10,000 units worldwide, got over $1 million revenue, and became profitable. Among our customers are advertising agencies, popular brands, and just curious tech-savvy people from all over the world. Also, currently our products are being distributed in 8 countries. One of our goals during SaltaCamp was building this scalable B2B sales funnel to attract new distributors and spread our brand and products globally. This week, we have 7 one-to-ones with experts in sales and performance marketing, which help us to unveil new tools and approaches in gaining sales. We managed to understand the perfect picture of our ideal B2B customer and prepare a strategy for generating leads. Speaking about real numbers, during this week we have got first warm leads after applying our new sales strategy, decreased abandoned checkout rate on our website, and raised the recovery purchases from 3 to 6.2%. Also, we launched the new website. But the most important, we have defined the new business strategy and got more prepared for a pivot. Now we are welcoming investments to scale our brand and launch in-app monetization. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you. Thank you. I really love, first of all, like when you today morning was sharing your bigger vision, the super good, like, you know, finally, I think that many people was amazed at what you have actually mind in the longer, like 4 or 5 years, like, you know, but I also like if you tell about numbers, and I like to ask now, like you're telling that you managed to increase percentage, how many people will win in checkouts. Can you a little bit like tell us what exactly did you change and how did you manage to increase that number?
Yeah, so thank you for the question. Hi, all. So basically, regarding the abandoned checkouts, this is the part of your sales and website where you can actually lose a lot of purchases when people actually they do not convinced like 400% to purchase your product. And here you can actually apply different strategics, you know, to resolve this issue. So basically, after one-to-ones, and after the Pavel speech on the first day of camp, we actually realized that we need to pay much more attention to this like short, small parts of our e-commerce process to actually increase the ROAS, increase the conversion rate in our website. So what we did, we built, so we basically defined absolutely new version of our ideal customer, updated version, and we built the new sequence of emails based on this like new strategy that we defined during the camp. And we applied this, and then we saw the results during like the first 2 days after it was launched. And it is pretty impressive. I hope it will like remain the same, but it was pretty impressive because it was like an insight from you know, different side, from different people that we didn't we weren't focused on this before.
Great, because you know the best way how to take this kind of events or like show your progress is always numbers. And I love it that you mentioned those things. The other thing what I want to ask, you mentioned also that your progress has been getting some serious leads. Can you also like open up what exactly did you mean with that?
Definitely. So we have two sales channels right now, especially in COVID era. We focused mostly on e-commerce because like many of our distributors, they like went on hold during this time. So one of our like main goals was actually focusing on how to build this expandable and predictable sales funnel where we can actually generate the new leads. So basically finding out new partners, new distributors who will be interested to sell our products in their store after the COVID is ended. So our main goal was to identify what actually steps we need to apply, we need to do to build those sales funnels. And we spoke with many mentors and got a lot of insights that we didn't know before and that we implemented during this week. And it is also impressive because, you know, we received like the actionable tools that we can actually work on. So what we did, we identified the ideal persona, ideal B2B customer that we need to approach. And based on that, we tried to find the leads that are similar to those persona. And then we started to communicate with them directly via email. So basically the the chance to get the reply much higher, because you know who you're referring to, you know who are addressing, and you know what those persons are interested in. So I think this helped us a lot as well in receiving the replies much higher than before, because you know like who you're targeting.
Awesome. And I also like that when you're basically doing this even live demo now, you have like two package of the of in your background. So always selling, always selling. Thank you, Margaret.
And thank you.
And the other thing I need to tell is that when we had in the morning like call with mentors and Andres Suzy, who was had one-on-one with you, mentions that, oh my God, I had call with them and I was talking this to my kids and oh my God, I need to buy them now because my kids so badly wanted it. So this was a good
That's
one.
Very cool.
So, use every moment to sell your product and, you know, promote it and so on. Thank you, Margaret.
Thank you.
But now let's again, like there are so many amazing people who are building their own company, different locations, because location is not important. And one of the key thing in our like camp is go to the, these new locations and find talented people who might be in the country where it's not in the first list when you think about startups. So this is why the next company is from Macedonia. Let's see what is Embed Social Building, please.
Hi, I'm Nikola, CEO of Embed Social. Today, unfortunately, we live in a different world where we have to buy our things online. But how do we know that the grocery will be delivered online? How do we know we'll get the right size of that t-shirt we ordered? For me, when booking a business trip, I always want to learn, is the Wi-Fi good in all the rooms, not just on the reception? Is there a lot of noise coming from the street below, or I can get a good night's sleep before an important meeting? Also, when going on vacation, I really want to see the beach on a sunny day, cloudy day, rainy day, so I can make a better decision. Embed Social is a marketing platform that helps businesses increase trust and conversions by using of social proof. What we've seen is that once customers have added our widgets to display their reviews, feeds, and stories on their website, they've seen increase in conversion rates and increase in sales. So far, we have more than 2,000 paying customers and our MRR is $70,000. We have big brands and small brands using the platform, such as Motorola and Ancestry, and been in Japan. And during this week, we got Janet Jackson as a new customer. Our team is 16 people strong, divided in two offices in Japan and Macedonia. We are four co-founders, me, Kate, Danny, and Ivana, and we've been working together for 10 years now. Our goal for this camp was to identify solutions for our bottlenecks in the product development cycle and define the growth team, so how to help us scale. So what we did is we redesigned the whole product development cycle based on the feedback we got from the mentors, and we hope this will help solve us our bottlenecks. We reorganized the organizational structure of the company and added some new roles that we defined we need people to hire. We learned that there are three things that matter in scaling a startup, and that's mentors, mentors, and mentors. So let's connect. And I will leave you with this feedback we got yesterday from Shopify about our latest integration. Thank you very much, and it was a pleasure.
Thank you, you, because I have heard so many good things about Macedonia, but you really like showed how great and hardworking startup founders can come from Macedonia. So first of all, thank you for you. But I have a few questions now. The first is that, did I hear correctly? Said you got new client Janet Jackson, really?
Yes, yes, we did actually. So basically, let me share the screen. So, okay, so this is Janet Jackson's website, and this is our Instagram widget. So it's pretty cool.
Wow, that's interesting. You definitely have very, very, very well-known person using your product now. But,
yes.
But the other thing I wanted to ask now is that you mentioned that you have expanded into Japan. And if I understood correctly, you have team in Macedonia and in Japan. First of all, why in Japan? Mm-hmm. Second of all, how much traction as of today you're getting from Asia?
So basically, Japan was an opportunity that we didn't plan. It just happened that one of our early employees just got back from his master's in Japan, and he was so pumped about our startup, and he talked with all his friends in Japan, giving them update what he is doing now. And one of his close friends said, so I want to become a reseller, or I want to join this, what you're doing, and sell it in Japan. And we started discussing, and we learned that a lot interesting things about Japan, and we identified that if we did this correct, we can have Japan as a really strategic market, that if we crack this market, then it will be very hard for any of our competitors to come and take our place.
Great.
And
yeah.
And for the traction is basically we are doing direct sales only in Japan at the moment. So we have big enterprise customers there. Edwin, they are a big fashion company, and I think that Brad Pitt is one of their celebrity endorsers. So we are doing pretty well there.
Sorry, did you say Brad Pitt?
Yeah, he, Edwin, our customer, is using Brad Pitt in their videos.
It just look randomly, you know, like the end, Brad Pitt is, what the fuck? but what about Ashton Kutcher? No?
No, not yet.
Ashton Kutcher has invested to Estonia startup very. Wow, you just keep surprising. It's just, I didn't know that people in Macedonia are so humble that say, I just, China Jackson, you know, Brad Pitt, you know, just, you know, no bragging, but this is what we have. But okay, the last question I have is that you're mentioning that you are doing now changes in your org chart. Can you a little bit tell more what you're changing now in the org chart?
So basically, we figure out that we grew really fast from 5 people to 20, and we got stuck. So we had more developers, but we were not releasing more features, and we needed to identify where the bottlenecks are and how to fix this before we start hiring again. So now we've added a few more positions, and then reallocated some talent to focus more on these positions that will help us set the proper infrastructure so we can start hiring new people again.
Awesome. And as I told you already today morning, so definitely Macedonia is in my to-do list. I really want to visit it, and not only visit, I really hope that, you know, you and with our help, we can really boost this startup ecosystem into the next level.
Thank you, Nikola. I think we can kickstart this together, and we are waiting for you here.
Absolutely. I will be there. You know, it's just, you know, traveling is slowly back, and I believe Macedonia is a great place to fly. And if people are looking at your background, it's sunny now.
Thank you.
Awesome. Thank you. And now we are traveling back to Ukraine, because next startup is Anuka. Let's say what they are up to and what they have built.
Hi, my name is Nikita. I'm 18 years old entrepreneur from Ukraine, CEO and co-founder of Nuka, a brand of sustainable goods on a mission to prevent waste of resources. Stationery is a habit of things for a million, but at the same time, our habit to write our ideas and plans in an ordinary stationery in paper notebooks have a really negative impact. It's a huge waste of resources. Only New York consumes so many notebooks that it equals 11 million tons of the trees every year. And 200 liters is an average spend of the water just to produce one paper notebook. So we decided to reinvent in stationery and make it more in a more sustainable way. And we developed a journal stationery. Our first product is Eternal Notebook, which is absolutely waterproof, tear resistant, and the main feature is that you can rewrite and reuse this notebook as many times as you want. Second product is Eternal Pencil, which writes with our special metal tip. It looks like and feels like you write with a regular pencil, but this pencil will never end. All of materials in our product is fully recyclable. It is conscious consumption because you can reuse it, and together we call them Eternal Stationery. It is powered by a mobile application that helps you to scan and organize all your handwritings in digital, in mobile application, before you will erase them from your physical product. With a selling price of $69, we got customer acquisition cost $16, and 20% of our customers order more than two packs of our product of Eternal Stationery. At this moment, we have 4,500 people in our community, $380,000 in revenue. Media such as BBC and Walk writes about us, and we won the most respectful product design award for our products. We see a huge opportunity in Asian market for our products, so we decided to validate this. Starting from the Taiwan that we launched previous months and got $100,000 result in revenue for 2 weeks of validation, and more than 2,300 customers at this moment. Previously, we just selling notebooks and pencil, but after running customer interviews, we discovered that most of our customers have an affinity towards sustainable lifestyle and prioritize Nuka specifically because of its environmental impact. For them, it's not just a notebook, it's a way to contribute towards sustainable future. So we understand that we are also work in the market of sustainable goods, which is grows 20% every year. And we believe that there is no future without sustainability of the product that we use every day. So we expand our brand mission to build a community around the vision of sustainable future and conscious consumption. Previous months, we have a testing batch. Previous month, we got golden samples from our mass production, and next month, we move forward to produce a first 3,000 units batch and start selling our product direct from our website, Nuka.me and Amazon in September. Our team is experienced in building products, hardware products, producing them and selling them as well. During the Salty Camp, we developed a new deck, testing new creatives on the Taiwan's market and got 40% growth compared to previous week, and working on a new brand positioning and website, which is amazing, and 60% of it done. Thank you.
Thank you, Nikita. Yeah, very, very interesting things and very interesting progress. So the first question is, so you're telling now that in July, which I just need to repeat today already, July, first 3,000 people can receive your, the new notebook. Did I understand correctly that actually months?
Yeah, fulfillment will be during the August and September. The first mass production batch will be launched in July, and it will be 3,000 units.
And basically, this is the people who did who paid you because of Kickstarter campaign, or who is that? This
Yeah. 3,000. First one, it's all the bakers in Europe and United States, and second batch is Taiwan and Asia market.
Great, and you mentioned that you are promising that your product is down without any trees. Did I understand correctly? Is that how you make those products? If you, because I love notebooks, this is my notebook here. So there is no paper that you use actually.
Our material, our paper is not actually a paper. It's a special polymer that is can be recycled, which allows you to reuse your product. It feels like and looks like ordinary paper, but it's like polymer.
Okay. And if, as you were talking about sustainable world and reducing waste, do you understand correctly that your vision is adding more products in the long term?
Yeah. More to push, like now we have mobile application, which we see as a holistic note-taking platform with a huge integration of the like physical handwritings on the paper or on your iPad. So this is direction of the mobile app. Direction of the stationery is to expand it with different formats for different needs as an analog stationery. And also we see and like a direction of creating a new sustainable goods, like not in the stationary category.
Okay. Thank you, Nikita. Thank you, Lyft 99 Kia, because if I'm not mistaken, you are now in exactly Lyft 99 office.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Bye-bye.
And
now we jump back to Estonia because we have a guy which officially has at this moment the most beautiful haircut of startup founders in Estonia. The next team up is Ups team and Martin with fresh haircut. You know, I actually had also time yesterday to do haircut, but come on, Martin is so freakingly more beautiful now because he had it today in live. I have never done that. But please, Ups team.
Hi, my name is Martin. I am the CEO of Ups Team. We are a platform for connecting busy car owners with mobile car washers. Yeah, I know. Boo-hoo, car washing, right? Well, we are here to make car washing sexy again. How? Well, with Ups Team, you don't have to do it anymore. Because in 2020, if you need a car wash, you have to drive back and forth, wait in a line, and find something useful to do with your time while someone is cleaning your car. For businesses, time means money. If you send your employees to a car wash, you're also paying for their salary and fuel. Aside from losing valuable hours that could be spent on generating money, you're actually paying 30% extra on top of the service fee. And of course, you'd think that in 100 years of car washing history, the car wash business is now better and more efficient. No, car wash places are still struggling with terrible unit economics, which means paying for rent, utilities, and also for the work hours where washers are waiting for other customers. We figured that the only way to make car washing sexy is to bring the car wash to your doorstep. But also, as we don't have the unnecessary maintenance or utility costs, we're able to pay more to the washers. All you need to do is place an order in our app. The washer comes to you fully equipped and uses only about 2 liters of water to clean your car both inside and outside. Feel free to call us Car Wash Hailing because everything else works as in Bolt or other similar companies. Our full stack platform is meant to digitize both the user side and the logistics side of car washing. You would be surprised by how much money there is to be found in dirt. More than 3 billion cars get washed every year. We are currently active in Estonia, Finland, and Poland, but by the next year, we want to launch in Germany and Norway as well. With 210 million euros to be found in those markets, we believe we can hit 20 million euros in revenue. We use a simple independent contractor model where we collect 30% net commission from the revenue our washers make. With an average of 200 euros revenue per day, that leaves us with about 5 million euros in gross profits in those markets. We've made more than 600,000 in revenue and we keep a high NPS score on that. Our customer acquisition cost and lifetime value ratio is about 20x and MRR makes about 50% of our monthly revenues. All three founders used to sell books door to door in America for 3 to 4 years in a row, working 80-hour weeks and getting some serious rejection while doing it. We've taken that hustle and experience with us, and now we're using all that to build the future of car care. We joined the Salto camp to figure out new and faster growth engine. We are grateful and also proud that during this week, we were able to make some critical decisions and take immediate action towards implementing some major strategic changes in our growth engine and also launch them in Poland right away. Feel free to contact us if you have any ideas or leads that can help us in our current markets. Also, let us know if you think that the future of car care could be an investment for you. My name is Martin. We are Ups Team. Thank you.
Wow, that was a good one. So how this started? Or something like that. It was a good beginning. I really liked it. But and I am very surprised indeed because you mentioned that in your pitch, you know. But as I see people are talking about, so can you really wash car using only 2 liters of water? Are you sure? Or you're sugarcoating it, Martin?
I'm going to build some tension on it. And before I answer that, because I'm not sure if I'm going to get this opportunity before we finish this meeting, I think I'm speaking for the whole team and all the startups that we feel privileged and absolutely amazed to be here in Saltocamp because it has been a huge wild journey and it couldn't be done without the team you guys have. So I want to say big thanks to Ragnar, Mari and all the mentors and all the team who has done this for us. But now to your question. So 2 liters of water, yes, it is actually can be done even with 0.5 liter. It just depends on the level of dirt you have and what car size is. But how it's done, it's basically a special detergent that gets sprayed on the car It liquefies the dirt, makes it soft, and then we just collect it into microfiber towels. That's how it's done.
That, and you know, that's allowed because this is exactly how we make the world better if we use less water. Because we are lucky in Estonia, we have a water. But if you think about globally, water is a big, big asset. So I really like that you actually, this statement is a good thing. And I definitely want to send cheers to Jaani Agomägi because most likely he was the most squeezed participant in our camp because he was this guy who was like, my hell, too much information, I'm so tired and so on. But I still have one question. You're telling that you are changing basically your market entry now from the B2B to B2C. Why so?
Well, firsthand, we just have a very, very good mentor right next to us, raising hundreds of millions here. And we just, since we have a very similar business model, then it just makes a lot of sense because, to be honest, our team is growing as well. We're just getting new investments and then also taking on new countries. Then, you know, you start getting a huge bunch of ideas on where you should put your focus. But we actually knew for a long time that we should be focusing on B2C first. But then we thought like, okay, B2B gives us like good retention and good packages. And then we just took this time during this week to check out the numbers. And we see that, you know, it just makes so much more sense because how it's done is that you first focus on the B2C. And then by B2C, you will get more inbound B2B applications, which you can easily convert into B2B customers. So you're not actually giving away the B2B sector, but you're just using a totally different strategy to get them.
Amazing. And I really like that your logo has even these like small things what unicorn have. So you are really, you are extremely prepared to being unicorn one day. Amazing. Oh, yeah. Thank you, Martin.
Yes, we will do it.
Honestly, like, you know, your energy and your team energy was just so freaking amazing in camp. So definitely me, Mari, and all of the Salto people was like saying thank you to bringing this energy because you guys have been cool with hell with selling books. And this is most likely the best training what every Salto founder can have. Thank you, Martin.
Yeah, grateful to be here. Thanks.
Now we jump back to Georgia because, come on, we have to be Georgia now. The next startup up is a live caller. Please, Nika.
Hello, I'm Nika, CEO and co-founder of LiveCaller. LiveCaller is real-time communication software designed for companies. Nowadays, customer service agent wastes around 1 hour of his working time daily. To help customer, it needs around 8 minutes, which is quite high, and it happens because proper communication tools are missing. LiveCaller solves this problem, and in addition, we saw that e-commerce companies increased their conversion rate about 20% using LiveCaller. LiveCaller is a widget installed by companies on their web page to communicate with their web visitors via chat, voice call, and screen sharing. So we united these three communication tools in one web-based widget. On the other hand, a company has a dashboard where they are communicating their clients, checking analytics, and improving their customer service department based on the statistical data. Based on our clients' needs, 2 weeks ago we have added omni-channel feature, which means our clients are communicating from our dashboard to their social media clients in Facebook Messenger, Viber, WhatsApp, and Telegram. Currently, we have 21 paying clients, which accumulates monthly MRR of $4,000 and plus. 7 more companies are on pipeline, and I am sure most of them will become our paying clients soon. We are 3 co-founders. Giga and me have entrepreneurial experience. We started our companies 8 years ago, which still operates successfully. Georgi has a great experience in development and he leads whole development team. In total, we are 9 in the team. During Salto Camp, we made strategic decisions. We are changing our pricing model, defined how to position our startup among competitors, decided to start content marketing, and finalized marketing and sales funnel. We have already started during the camp to test new strategy and we got initial results already. From LinkedIn Outreach, we have got 3 demos booked and 7 free trial clients signed up. We are looking for investment €200,000, which will be used for product development and sales. Nika from LiveCaller.
Thank you, Nika and LiveCaller. Definitely great progress. If I looked, what did you achieve in 100 hours? I wanted to deep dive into one thing. You're telling that you made changes in pricing. Can you open it up? What exactly the change in pricing?
Hello, everybody. First of all, thank you for the camp. To say it simply, we simplified our pricing model. We are changing it to a much more simpler one. Because we are calculating based on the features customer used, based on the number of users they had. Now we will only switch on the number of users and we will unite the product as a one. So we won't split the product into the features.
Okay. And you also mentioned that you had 3 demos and 7 trials. So can you also like open up from which country this was or what kind of clients this did you got in this week?
Sure. So this week we narrowed down our target audiences on our LinkedIn outreach funnel. And this new outreach we sent only to the e-commerce type of companies who has around 100,000 visitors per month. So we narrowed down it. And also we got new message for them that not only the communication tool, but also we help to increase conversions. So it turned out to be interested for our potential clients. So we had a really good response.
Awesome. Thank you, Nika. Thank you, LiveCaller. Thank you, Georgia, for that.
Thanks.
And now we have one more startup. And, you know, one more time. That's crazy. Like Estonia is 1.3 million people, but we are seeing that startup communities are growing in different cities. And it's, by the numbers, is impossible because all countries 1.3, which is like, you know, it's not even enough for one city. But the next startup is from Tartu. And yeah, I actually are born there. I have spent my first 20 years in that. So Remoto, you're next up, please.
Hi, my name is Maidis. I'm one of the co-founders and CEO of Remato, and we are digitalizing construction industry. Construction is 10% of the global economy, yet it is still one of the least digitalized industries. There is over 7 million construction companies in Europe and Americas, and majority of them are small and medium businesses. Most of them are struggling every day with endless repetitive paperwork, poor group performance, and deadlines with harsh penalties. But this has to change. Everything used to be fully analog on paper, but now for some time it has already moved towards digital. But the problem is, for example, Excel, it is digital, but data is still processed manually. If digital is done right, we can start to automate processes and ask the next step, predicting problems and giving smart advice to make better decisions. We are building a simple and holistic software platform for small and medium blue-collar construction companies. We have 2 parts. We have the mobile application for the working crew to track everything and have the information in hand. And then we have for the office, all the planning, real-time overview, and then reporting. Our clients are saving time, earning more, and they can forget stress. We currently have over 100 paying companies generating close to €10,000 monthly recurring revenue. We are growing around 10 to 15% month over month. Our average client is around 20 employees, generating few million euros yearly revenue, and they are paying us average around €100 per month. And the feedback is also great. For example, one client told us that after first month of use, they saved €1,600 just because the salary-based data was more precise. There is competition, but those solutions are still too complex for small and medium businesses. And by far, the main competitor is still Microsoft Excel. We are going to kill it with the best user experience for frontline working crew. And this is crucial to capture the baseline data and start automating processes for the office. And we have the strong team to execute on this. We have the 4 co-founders. First, our CTO Ranno has close to 10 years of full stack development experience, and he has been building SaaS businesses since he was 19 years old. Then Thomas, our sales guy, he has over 10 years of experience in different construction roles in object management and also selling rental equipment to the construction businesses. And then Seem, he has over 20 years of experience in running product teams and digitalizing different industries. And myself, I have over 8 years of background in user experience design. Just before Remato, I came from Booking.com product team. During the Salto camp, we had two main points that we wanted to work on. First, a major product update that included full redesign and new scheduling functionality. We made great progress in there, and we are going to release it in the coming weeks. Second, international sales and partnerships. We launched new ad campaigns in 5 countries, Lithuania, Romania, Bulgaria, Ukraine, and South Africa, and reached out to many resellers, and we are now in talks with 2 potential Remato resellers. During the Corona crisis, we raised our 2nd fundraising round, and now we are opening up for a few more angels to jump in with the same terms, just to boost our international expansion. Thank you, and enjoy the rest of the evening. Bye.
Thank you, Madi. Thank you, Tartu. Definitely very good, hugely good, like, you know, energy and effort. And if I remember correctly, you was the guy who really worked until 4 a.m. and then was going to the back to the home to have a few hours of sleep. So this is just, you know, this is exactly how you do this event. This is exactly how you get the new results in. But the one thing I wanted to ask, like, there's no questions that the opportunities are freaking amazing, because this construction is, sorry to say, totally fucked up. Like, you know, like, but my question is, like, I think that construction market needs disruption. But as we talked with mentors as well, as an example, you know, Estonia is pretty digitalized. You know, we have mobile phones, you know, our granny and grandpa using mobile phones. But if you go out of Estonia, for example, to Germany, those people use still fax machine. Like, what? Fax machine? And what has been your experience if you talk outside of this bubble in politics and Finland? Because I'm most likely feeling that in many, many countries, construction is so low level that people most likely don't have even mobile phones. So give us a sense, like, what has been your experience when you need to go to this huge opportunity, but which basically digitalized is like, not here, but like beyond the whatever, how you can onboard and get them using the platform when they might even refusing using mobile phones?
That's a really good question, Ragnar. I think, at least from our experience in our home market and in Finland, and when we have talked with other markets, is that even in here, everybody in the construction field doesn't have a smartphone, at least. But for that, we have also a regular cell phone support. So you can just call in, your timer starts, you can call out at the evening and the timer stops. And besides that, we have also in Estonia lots of clients who are not using the start-stop system or calling at all. They have a manager who is doing the, like, basically looking out of the window. Okay, this guy came now, start, and this guy went away now to stop, basically like that. But then again, time tracking and employee management is just one part of the platform. And this can be in some countries where not everybody has the device themselves, can be done by the manager. And we also, some clients are using RFID cards, like the Tor cards with the scanner on the Tor when they come to work. And they just swipe the card to start the tracker. And we are planning to integrate also fingerprint readers and stuff like that.
And you know, it can't be better. Like, golden helmet is really level we have never seen. Like, we never seen. That's already very good statement, you know. And when we talk with mentors and one of your investors, the one thing about getting people so freakingly excitement is opportunity. Exactly. We have Toggle, time tracking, you know. We have Pipedrive, which was going into areas when people did not use any CRM, but nailed one thing, UX. In that sense, we are freaking loving it. But let me ask one more question. So you was launching now these different campaigns, testing out new markets, and you started to see some new leads. How many new leads you have been getting in last 12 hours? From where, what countries? Have you had time to look? How many leads did you got? from what countries and what kind of companies?
Good question again. So we launched the campaign yesterday, like quite late after 10 o'clock. And since we did the launch in the same time zone as we are, so most of the campaign was just up during the night. And when I came in morning, then during our morning update, the list started popping in for one moment. And I don't know the exact count, but it's definitely over 10 already. And interesting thing is that we launched basically equal campaigns in Eastern European countries and South Africa. And South Africa is generating far more traffic, like far more traffic.
And let me just remind you, South Africa was the country which Bolt really pulled it off. Yeah. That's why we talk about Bolt, because they managed to open South Africa when no one didn't believe into them. And they opened just with Skype and so on, didn't visit it. So if you can actually have clients in South Africa, that can be your opportunity to change everything fundamentally, isn't it?
It is. It is definitely. I think it's a bit of interesting thing for us as well that we are definitely gonna explore more, especially as one of the partner contacts that we also got is also from South Africa, and we just reached out in LinkedIn, and they basically responded in the first like hour that yeah, like we are let's talk, and the interesting about the leads is also like those are actual registered accounts, and we checked like multiple of them. They are actually like legit construction companies that list seems to be, and they're not like random contacts or something like that.
Awesome. It can't be better last pitch as you did, Remato, with golden helmet. You know, I think it's unbeatable. Thank you, Midas.
Thank you. Bye.
This was the 13th pitch, and now we will have exactly half hour. Oh, let me calculate now. 5:05. Let's be back because we have now half hour DJ here playing some music. Let's get the mood. I need to buy new wine because I'm already out of the wine. Everybody can go and have some chill because we will be back exactly 17:05 by Estonia, 17:05 by Ukraine, and every other country. Please calculate what is GMT plus G, because we will be back to just wrap it up, to do some kind of summary, because first of all, every founder, every participant was voting who are the most helpful founder, who would say invest their own cash if they would be investors. But it's also who was the most helpful mentor, and most importantly, all the mentors, all the investors had voting, and we will know who they found the most interesting, hardworking teams after exactly 30 minutes. Listen music. I will be back exactly 5:01, 17:05. See you soon.
Halli taiva alla. Ehkä yritsäni tihti. Hallis olla karmi. Kaitseks seikor. Saili kaila panna. Selles kõiges alatasa. Hotel.
you still want to hit it, y'all get a single girl.
And if you got beef, you get beat to a pole.
Money, hey, party, and reeling,
and rocking. Dep, dep,
girls go, all y'all talking. The song and dance, keeping you in the trend.
If you don't bum a record, I got my X band.
I see it,
I think it,
I see it,
I beat it.
I love rap, man, you better don't give the end.
Who we got the bottle, you got the cup. Come on, everybody, let's get brass monkey.
This one's going out to the fabulous fleas.
That this was chemistry, but with these chemicals then, how is this good for me? Her life gets better, she bred, her man goes out of his head, like birds of a feather, so we bled, let's go together, and she said, so what's the altitude? I said, it's out of sight, what's with the attitude? And she said, it's alright, so what's the altitude? I said, it's out of sight, what's with the attitude? She said, it's all right. She said, let's get away now. Let's go down by the bay. She turned her hand my way now. Watch out what you say now. Now, the things you've been through make it seem like nothing could ever really last forever. But if you try, girl, we can do some things. She gave me headphones. Said, have you heard this sound? I think I've heard this one is totally underground. I wouldn't let her go then. She wouldn't let me go. Just ask the neighbors, man. It's unbelievable. I played the morning rising, she played the setting sun. She said she couldn't stay when her night had just begun. So what's the altitude? I said it's out of sight. What's with the attitude? And she said it's alright. So what's the altitude? I said it's out of sight. Without abandon, we dance, we party all night. We party all night. We party all night. We made the perfect day when we played the night sun. She said she couldn't stay when her night had just begun. She wanted me to know what she didn't know herself. Said I was one among others. Hey, now that's something else. We played a vocal mission to play the cosmic sky. How can we make the distance? You've always known my eye. We're letting people know what we now know ourselves. Now we are one of my others. Hey, now that's something else. She gave me headphones. Said, have you heard this sound? You know I've heard this one, girl. Let's get out of town. This love is like a drug and we bonded chemically. We're letting you know better, living through chemistry.
One,
they had empty first 10 rows of noise in. The fiesta's popping and all fingers pointed. I read Papa's got the whole crowd jointed. Checking what eyes kept me sweating, no why. I can hear them in word fly, keep the gleam in your eye. Come mucho drum roll on time, let the home blow. Gas through the pedal like metal at a corn show. The rhyme mic with the shit, load the block. I grab the mic and freak the rhythm till there's no more bala. So mi palabra, pero booze and ha-ha. That includes all who goes and see la la. So do the cha-cha, who can call me papa. What a thing for action, hunt until my nana. Down for hi-hat crash and whiplash. City night, bright light and earth stash. De onda muchacho arriba las manos, gabacho moreno penetra tu barrio, le enseño un rola cero rock back frente. Esto pa' la gente. Like chanclazos, deep like fregadazos. Still got the coke and rum and flex the brazos. Then I hit you from a different angle. Lake sweep, cheap shot, bird shit, straight cop. Soy el twin, pistolero, guerrero. Don't be afraid of that. A matter of fact, I got like 10,000 maniacs in the crowd on a very good night. But keep it hype for a fraction of that. To get the fanny like that. Tronica en el aire, todos quieren baile. Plus my sick Latin style, dale. But when they come, I can feel the drum. Don't know the word, but you can hum.
The next spin wreck, end of discussion. Touching tones and rotating wax, bringing it back to the break. Ain't no faking this, we making this hot. We lock the needle in the groove, manipulation the moves, bringing the drama, playing the flares and stands on ya. Bass hits the bomb ya, reverberating and invigorating the brain. We maintain and boost the gain and sink your body right down to the brain. You hear the speaker strain and contain the co-creations, the salsa, the next man, a syncopation. Placing the set, we rep the intercontinental flow for your mental. So step into the center, beware of those who enter. It's madness. Your thoughts get spun, your mind stunned.
Bar one, moving amongst the madness. The next man, this all to you. Bar two, moving amongst the madness.
Let your body collide to the rhythm provide.
Bar one, moving amongst the madness.
The next man,
this all to you.
Bar two,
moving amongst the madness.
Let your
it's different from the jam. My hands are motion, causing commotion. Who puts a buzz in every speaker? The soul song with the next man sound that's bound to reach you in your urban area. Feel the hysteria is ringing. God, I'm ringing the alarm like tennis ball, so heed the warning. Sonics be forming, rhythms they rain down to wet you and stretch the conceptions of the uses of the text and the vinyl. But Luby dropping beats to break your spinal. While DJ Search brings it back with the rap, then they the tables get torn, showing the style to impress the next fader finesse. And all that mess. We stressing the point, coming with hot joints to hit you. The next step, flexing the set, bound to get you.
Moving amongst the madness. Fall one.
Absolutely fascinating. What kind of instrument is that?
The turntable.
Almost complete. Okay.
It was uncut and you just defiled it. End of the night, let's try to revive it. We'll make it home, you know we'll survive it. No time for insight, stopped at the red light. Everyone jumped out the ride. Shook, but I'm hype, never been the type. So bitch, get the fuck out the car.
Lucy shades on, flying on the FDR, Gucci guilty cologne, a bitch named Caviar, loyal to the game, now she's fucking with the king of hearts, good pussy cleaning my wallows, while I'm writing darts, feeling like Don Johnson, the man from Miami Vice, casinos, they stop all bets when they hand me dice, Farragamo foot rugs, two couples in the black rave, white Range Rover, two white boys in blackface, be easy, we bumping staying alive by the Bee Gees, bitch sniffed all my fucking coke being greedy. I grabbed the jacket, she grabbed the Fiji and threw up Domino's pizza all on the TV. Said, fuck you, Ghostface, and cracked my CD. She took one leg out the car and took that pee-pee. Told my man behind the wheel, she's feeling freaky. His girl said, uh-uh, bitch, fuck you, Kiki.
Thank you.
Check one, two. Later. Okay. It is exactly 5:05. It is exactly now being back. Making summary. Giving some heads up. Telling some feedback from community, from mentors, and so on. First of all, we have to memorize and tell huge, huge heads up for the Estonian government. Estonian Europe, Estonian Development Cooperation, Startup Estonia, because that's the reason why we are here. Because they asked us, Salto and Lift 99, can we do something to help Georgia, Eastern Europe to more connecting? And here we are. We ended up with 13 startups from 6 countries. But most importantly, to reach to that point where we are now, we had to go through with hundreds and hundreds of applications, read through with them. What has been very painful lately is that because of this up and down, what I think that in the 100 years, no one have never seen, there has been basically, indeed, it had affected heavily, heavily, almost every company in the world. And it was so sad to see, like, some startups have to go through so bad changes, said literally in last week when we was preparing for this camp, so there was some companies who just literally had to tell, sorry, all of my team has burned out. We have battled so hardly last 2-3 months. We just don't have power now to join this camp. And you know, as a founder, as an entrepreneur, I can just feel that pain. And I felt so badly for them. But then we got this amazing group of 13 startups and founders together, and the magic happened. But before we start to announce the summary of this event, because the winners are every single one of them here, we have to say indeed huge, huge applause for all of these people, all of the mentors who just joined and they was like, yes, I want to help them. I want to share as much possible and, you know, help them to the next level. Give back to your community. So let's make clap to all of these amazing mentors who joined this. And before we go to the next slide, I think that you need to understand one thing. Wow, this takes like, it's organizing this when everything is changing in the world where nothing is given anymore. It's just like extremely tough. And there is many people behind of that. You can see some names here, but there are many, many people. And I need to now basically show the one of the main person here who has been going through with the biggest pain and so on. So this is the Mari. And I think that all of the participants and mentors know how hardworking she is just to make sure everything works by the clock, hour by hour, second by second, and so on. So let's make big hand to the first Mari and also Anneli next to her. Let's make big, big thanks to this power team. Woo! Because one more time, when I talked with even the mentors, the Martin Henk, you know, like, come on, we have built some great company, like 90,000 paid clients, you know, 10 years. He was like, oh my God, after one day, and this camp is 5 days, and preparation is just so much more because we need to go through this application and we want to be sure that the right folks get the chance. For us, it's super important so we can get this right group of people to joining this camp who is super motivated and not only like they would push the company next level, they would take this, what they learn here, and they would start to giving it back soon and building new communities, whatever they are. And that's why maybe this updates when we run with CEOs and you can start to hear how unique is this group of the CEOs and founders and so on would say, yes, I want to change Macedonia. I want to change Nigeria, Ukraine, Georgia, so on and so on. This is why we do this. This is why we are pulling it off, because the original secret sauce of this startup mecca, Silicon Valley, is giving back to community. And this is the driving force behind of this event. And this is exactly, I think that this time we really pulled off this magic. Because even today, like when we had the last update with the CEOs, I was like, oh my God, this is so amazing. Let's have update after 2 months. It's like, yeah, well, indeed we can have update after 2 months because this journey is just going on. It's just, you run marathon, but you have the sprints. And this is pure magic to see the happening. So, let's go to the next slide now. So before we will give heads up to some founders, some startups, let's give heads up to mentors because like I think that Nicola from Embed Social was mentioning, it's mentors, mentors, mentors. So let's see, we asked from every participant, every founder, CEO, and you know, very valuable manager, and you know, who they found was the most helpful mentors. And let's see, what was the vote giving us? The first mentor, which got so much positive energy, was Joanna from Poland. Thank you, John, for joining us, because like I think that what people loved about you, how much you helped to understand how to build the growth, how to push it to the next level and so on. And again, you are giving us that you are going from the Poland and connecting exactly, connecting us with these things what you have learned was just pure magic. Thank you, Joanna. So next, let's see, who was the next one who was giving so much positive energy? The mentor number two by the positive energy was Martin Henk. Woo! So, you know, first of all, this is the mentor who joined the event and was like, oh my God, there is one amazing team. Here is my money, I'm in. And this is exactly what we are building here. We are building here, like, you know, like community which can give this from founder to founder. And I don't know what happened, but you know, after this fire chat we had with him on Tuesday, I was, some people called me. I was like, yeah. I was like, oh my God, that's so amazing story. I received messages and Martin told me, but I don't know what happened, but so many people started to email me and so on. So yes, Martin was insanely helpful. He decided to invest one company, but he actually is invested to the two other companies already. So he really is like sometimes making so fast decisions, but also like he's the founder. He knows what you're going through and he's now pensioner, you know, just giving back to community. But yeah, Martin was intensively helpful, like Oliver is telling. But let's see now. So what, who was the most helpful founder by your vote? Let's see, who is the most helpful founder is, boom, Pavel. Woo! You know, yeah. Pavel is, I don't know what he eats. I actually know what he eats. He eats burgers. So, but I think that this guy, if people know that there is one amazing unicorn, which is Bolt from Estonia, but they don't know that behind of that success is this guy, who is just real robot machine and so on, who is just cracking in the milliseconds the things into the place, analyzing and so on. And I think that what he really needs is having more rest. So what we do for him now, and some other people, is that we have him private party. Next slide, please. So yes, so from 45 minutes from Tallinn, this is one magical place I have been putting a huge amount of my energy to build basically nature resort in the next of the lake, next of the old manor. And Pavel will be the big star. He can invite like 10 friends to that. And we are also involving some other mentors who are joining. So Pavel will have exactly now a party, middle of the nature. Sorry, no burgers. But some good drinks from Jani Hansa and so on. So Pavel, I should call him now, but he's not picking up the phone anyway. So when he can join that. So this is our big, big thank for these people who pulled it off. I hope Shauna will fly in maybe, but let's see, or like Sebastian. Yeah, and Philip from Germany, you should also fly in, come on. Like you have been already investing and so on. So please, there is direct flights from, I think, Munich and Frankfurt already to Tallinn. The flights are working, you know. I know people who has been like in the airports, it's actually working, you know. So don't worry, it's safe side here and no burgers. Okay. Thank you, all of the mentors. It was an amazing effort. So, and come on. You know, it's not about the mentors. It's about these 13 teams who was just working so hard and, you know, just built the company, give back to community and show that you can not only survive is the next first level, but you can make change. Yeah, Philip, by the way, totally, we can do it in August, don't worry. Just write those dates and we can talk with you. So don't worry. Just give us the dates and we are making it happen. Actually, you can already fly now, by the way, Philip. Okay, but this 13 team was amazing and this is why we are doing it. Just like finding these right people, spreading this know-how worldwide and helping founder no matter where you are. Because like if you're born in US, Silicon Valley, you already won lottery. If you are in Stanford, Google, you can just go and fundraise from Sequoia, from Horowitz and so on, just, you know, because you are in the right place. But Estonia, Ukraine, or Nigeria, or Macedonia, or you know, like Hungary or Georgia, that's not the first choice for startup investors. That's why we are doing this. So thank you to this all of 13 teams indeed. And let's see. The next slide. Who was the most helpful founders? Because one of the things, what we really want to see here, how we can build the community set. We help you, and you are starting to help other founders immediately because you already have learned so much, you know some things. And let's say you was voting who was these three most helpful founders. The first is Laszlo. Woo! So let me see, is he now live here? Laszlo.
Yeah, I am. Hi.
So stage is yours. You can talk now. Your emotions and so on, please.
Thank you very much. I didn't expect that at all. And thank you for everybody. I totally agree with what you said before, that this is an amazing community. I really like to spend time with smart people, and you are the best. So thank you, and thank you for Salto for organizing this, and maybe meet you next year in person.
Oh yeah, absolutely. We hope to meet in person also. We want to connect you more in community. So as we hope, you have this like big group of people in your Slack community we have as well. We really want to be sure that we can help each other in long term. That's why we are adding also in our Lift 99 online community. Thank you, Laszlo. So let's see who else did founders, startup people there. Who was the helpful people? The second was, ta-da, Oliver. Woo! Oliver.
Thanks, everyone.
So your stage is yours. People really liked your help, please.
Yeah, I'm glad that I could help Martin to freeze his computer. So it was definitely very helpful for his productivity at this point. really, that's really honorable for me to, you know, have this kind of feedback from you guys. And I'd definitely like to get in touch to you in like 2 months or so, and let's keep in touch and see what's the progress and how we can help each other to move further.
Absolutely. I like it, you know, in this, the best community, just people raise hands and say, you know, can I do this? Yes, you can. And this is the fact that Oliver's like, yeah, let's have update after 2 months. Let's just keep pushing it. It's amazing. And the fact is Oliver is building, has built a community in Pärnu, in small city of Estonia, is an example how much he has been helping. Thank you, Oliver. So, and now one more person was basically received so much positivity and someone how much he was helping. And for him, as I understand, we are giving even possibility to join and being here in Lyft community in Tallinn for the 2 months together with the team what he has. Let's see who was this person. The most helpful founder was Martin from Ops Team. Woo!
For real?
For real? I think that this was your new haircut. Stage is yours, please.
No way, guys. Oh my God, I feel so honored. Thank you. I actually thought that I wasn't helpful at all. But I guess, what can I say? I mean, it's a result of this synergy, I guess, we had. I mean, all the startups were great, and I really love that we had this kind of very good, like, energy around the whole thing. And I mean, I'm absolutely amazed. I was thinking that Artur is going to get that spot. But thank you, guys. Yes, definitely keep in touch, and however we can help each other out, that's a big thing. Thank you.
And just an example, you know, when we had the first Tbilisi event back in November, the most helpful founder was Ryan from Ask Robin. Da-da, after 4 months, 2.2 million round. So this is also like something to think about, you know. So thank you, Martin, because like definitely you have been going through is the best training for being such a founder, selling books and so on, but definitely it had trained you to help community and people feel that and so on. So thank you, Martin, and all Ops team. Thank you. So now we will move into the next level. And you know, like, we are starting this journey now. Like, it is just like small, extremely intensive sprint. But building a company many times takes not week, not months, not year, but 10 years. So what we asked from every founder and every participant in this camp was, if you would be angel as of today, where you would put your money? Because many times, like, you know, the best investors are the founders, the people who know deeply what it means to build a startup. So that's most likely super interesting thing to know what other founders found so interesting, so promising, to basically said, say, I want to look it and never know, maybe one day they put money in. So, and we are also telling now the top three out of these 13. The third place, founder's favorite startup to invest is, ta-da, Codeberry. Woo!
Third place, runner-ups are, so thank you. I don't know what to say again. So it's thank you. Maybe you can send the money right now, and that would be pretty nice. I mean, you just got some, like, Pizzata just got a 100K investment just closed. So, yeah, that would be nice. Just send it.
Yeah. So, yeah, just, you know, publish your, like, bank account and so on, so other founders would know where to, like, just, you know, wire the money. Thank you,
yeah,
Lars.
Yeah.
Thank you. And let's see who also, like, was receiving so much positive energy. The second place was Upsteam. Woo!
Oh my God, again. Cool. Thank you guys. if you have to say that as well, that if you want to put money in, go to Funderbeam. You can do it every day. You can trade with the shares and everything. I mean, cool. Cheers.
Yeah, I think that maybe you should do next crowdfunding using founders, because they are actually smart as they know actually how tough it is and how cool you are. So thank you, Martin. Thank you, Upsteam.
Cheers. Thank you.
Let's see. Before we are sending the first team, what we had with that one, Mari, please remind me. What was the, like, we are also giving heads up for the first team and what we keep for them. Elar, wait for a second. Yeah, so the next team, which was basically the founders and camp participants' favorite, even though the it was so close. So, like, end of the day, all you basically had amazing progress. There is no, like, one is more and bigger, but we just did statistically putting it out. And for this team, again, like, we want to give you, like, here 2 months so you can join here. You can be around, like, literally. Before this live, I was talking with one angel investor who was just flying here from US. So maybe you should speak with him and so on. So the founder's favorite startup is in camp 4. Let's see. Hugo Legal. Woo!
Whoa. Thank you. Thank you from us so much from us. Aga is also with me. This is unexpected. So I don't have the right words in my head just popping out. But I guess if other startups consider to invest in Hugo Legal, so I will send you the term sheets. Or is that okay?
Please do, yeah. Yeah, I think that the one amazing thing is that even we talked in the mentors group was like, you know, like Andre Susi mentioned, oh my God, I know for myself how much I would need it in different place. different stages of my life, that kind of service. So no questions that this thing what you build is needed. Thank you, Arthur, and the whole Hugo Legal team. Thank you.
Thank you, Ragnar. Thank you, Salto Camp. You guys are amazing. Thank you. Thank you so much. And thank you for the other startups for this type of recognition as well. This was really unexpected. Thank you, guys.
Thank you. So we also was giving word to basically mentors after, like, you know, the most active teams, as I understand, had 12 mentors meeting. But not only that, they had like round tables. They have masterclasses. So in the total, we had more than 160 calls. And actually, this is official because you had so many follow-ups and so on and so on. But yeah, we had masterclasses, we had round tables, we had like fire chats. So lots of things happened. So we was discussing and ask mentors as well, who was this she which standed out for them? And again, let's see what they was giving on. The third place by the mentors is Smart Sender. Woo! Hayak.
Yes.
Please.
Thank you. I don't know what to say. This is first time we win something. thank you guys for this amazing program. It was really, really cool, especially to talk with all the other startups and understand that you are not alone. And sometimes you pretty feel yourself that you need to talk with somebody who can maybe suggest something, recommend, or just share experience. And this kind of meetings always help to get all this energy sharing, and this give another boost for another sprint in this huge marathon thing. Thank you, guys.
Woohoo! And the good thing is that if I talk with the mentors, like, you know, we just keep talking, was that indeed, like, this is just a 1 week and you can change everything in just 100 hours. You can just start it and you can feel power, how much you can do. But what I love is that how much mentors said, you know, I want to follow up with that guy. I want to follow up with second guy. And I definitely felt there are many people who will have follow up with you, Hayak. And, you know, I think that the one thing which is the beauty of this founder is that he was so humble. I was like I'm like, he had a question that, do I am ready for the investors? I think this is clear. You are ready. It's now up to you. Do you want even to have them and how to build it up? Because you have already amazing traction. It seems to be just you are just too humble. Like you even like showing your numbers smaller than everyone else is seeing. But I think that's the best founders, you know, just they are so busy building product and that's just, you know, going around and selling and funding. But just I'm building a product and I want to be sure it's helpful. Thank you, Hayak and Smart Sender.
Thank you very much, guys.
So again, let's see, we have still two more slides. After that, two more announcements, but let's see. Again, this is like small things that mentors have felt. They really spend right time and, you know, good with some people. So the mentor's favorite number two is Codeberry. Woo-hoo! Laszlo.
We improved the place. Yes, thank you. Let me just reflect on that. So obviously, it's really heartwarming that the mentors also liked us. But as András said, showed it in the final pitch demo, we took 55 pages of notes. So, I mean, you know, we can't really write that fast as we speak. So the density of the information was like really flowing through. So I'm really, really happy, really grateful for all the mentors, because you said so many great things. And yes, not 65, but 55. There's a comment about that. So even we learned from Mari and Annalie and Ellie, so from the Salto team as well, because there were so many things going on here and there. So
Yes, it's flattering. Thank you for the second place, and it's really, really good. But the special attention should go to the mentors themselves, and you deserve that retreat. So spend it well and take some rest. And yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you, Laszlo. Yeah, it sure is super intensive, but definitely, like, in every CEO update we had, Laszlo had the energy. I don't know where he got it, but he has some balance very right, because every freaking update and so on, just top-notch, you know, just you prepare and do, and the taking 65 pages of notes is not only record, but it shows something. You know, in that road to building a company, you need to be open to learn every day, every hour, every week and months, because everything is changing so freakingly fast. And this is why we run this event, because, you know, some things which we learned in Pipedrive many years ago, sadly, it's not relevant anymore. Because, like, things has changed, literally, in the last 2-3 months, many playbooks is broken. And with all the like good things that we have, we want to be sure that we can give this direct know-how to people who deserve. And Goodberry really was motivating for so many mentors. He said, thank you. Like, you know, I just received messages like, thank you for choosing so right selection of the starters. I feel so like highly that my time as a mentor was spent in the right people. And you know exactly, you know, many mentors from Estonia, but not only, you know, from Netherlands, from, you know, Poland and so on, and so from Germany and so on. And, you know, we helped, you know, Goodberry from Hungary. It's exactly the magic. Building this virtual Silicon Valley, which is not, you know, just only like in one country, but this goes through the borders and so on. Because, come on, everything is possible now. So thank you, Laszlo, for this huge effort. So we have one more startup to mention, and after that, two more things to say, and then we can wrap it up. You can like open and have, depending on the people, some people will have like maybe some wine, beer, you know, cider, whatever. Some people will take like power nap of 12 hours. But yes, there was one more startup which received so much positive energy from the mentors, and it was like, wow. They're just pushing, they're just learning and so on. So the mentor's favorite of the Camp 4 is Vibarex from Pärnu. Woo!
Oh my God. Thank you. This is really cool.
So, Oliver, the good news is that, you know, I think that we want to help you more and more, you know. So, not only Pärnu, but you have one team member in Tallinn, as I know. But, you know, just you can join here, be here. But stage is yours. I don't know, like, what did you eat? But people felt that you just progressed, you learned. Please.
Yeah, I mean, we just started the week with, like when we came, we weren't really prepared actually for it, because we had so much stuff going on already, and we were like, okay. And then eventually we invited our CTO in, and then we just, at one point it clicked and we went into the full hackathon mode. So I think that actually happened already on Monday. So, yeah, I mean, it's really great. I mean, big props to you guys, I mean, for organizing all that and really for choosing so good founders on this as well. I mean, we also learned so much from others, and we also learned insane amount from all the mentors. And I think the best part is that the next following weeks are going to be, you know, even more intense, because we now need to use all that information that we gained. So yeah, thank you so much for the, I'm really honored.
Woo! Wow, what a camp. And I need to tell that, you know, like, I think that Martin really nailed it. It is just intensively tiring, but to seeing how much startups can achieve in these 100 hours, how much you learned, how much we make impact, is this magic energy why we are doing that. And believe me, we ever never planned to have like 3 online campaigns in 3 months. It's just intensively against of everything. But what the hell? We had the plant in Tbilisi, and said, we want to help you. But this energy, what we got back, is just intensively huge. So one more time, I want to thank, first of all, we have next slide, most likely. Like, I want to thank exactly Estonia government, Estonia Startup Estonia, to pushing us to do that. And come on, every freaking team who was part of that is already a winner. You know, but it is important. And I need to basically memorize. So there was also every team who achieved something. So, and I think that the one startup which received like cash or promise to invest was like Pistata, which is an amazing thing. And you know, I have been following this team like a little bit longer, by the way. So they joined our Lift 99 in Kiev. I have received so many updates from them. And you know, I'm just look this like the what they did in the camp, how they have developed and so on. And I remember that there was a one thing in this slide which told us that they have like one slot for the one angel. So not the official announcement, but Stacia and Roman, I can fill that last angel slot myself.
Finally!
My God, it took so long! That's great. We're happy to welcome you as well.
Yes, we've been talking last few months how we could, what we could do so you could join. So it's super cool. Thank you.
We were about, actually, we were having like jokes about having this. We had this question mark on this slide, and we were about like, maybe let's put like, Ragnar, why are you not still investing in us? So, yep. That's great. Thank you.
Thank you.
We think we can be. In terms of all of your major investments and a lot of like things in your portfolio of startups, we think we can be a rock star there. We feel that we can be.
Yeah. You know, yeah, I think that, you know, the one thing which I'm more and more looking, you know, we had like, so, like, we had Wednesday chat with Alex Kuda from RayStream, and this is a dream and amazing to work with Alex from RayStream and helping and so on, you know. And, you know, RayStream is your paying client, you know, more and more listening. I was like, okay, maybe I can help, you know. This was my biggest question, you know. But, yeah, this was great time. And, you know, the good news is that, one more time, like, you have been making just few steps now, and many people want to follow you. And, you know, I have definitely one follow-ups with some other teams and so on. But this is how you build it, step by step, pushing it, like, every day and every week to the next level and so on. And the good news is that it's not only about you, guys. The 30 starters who have learned, it's also us mentors, the Salto team, and if not, what we learn from you. Literally, like, you know, day by day and, you know, hour by hour. And what is good is that, you know, if you wrap it up now, the last thing what I can tell you is that, you know, we have learned so much from this event that literally if you had event, I had also call with Wednesday with Singapore. And, you know, I'm happy to tell that our next event will be actually together with Singapore biggest or like Southeast Asia biggest conference. So, so there's something here, and now we are getting already like, wow, the camp is so amazing. Let's build bridge between Europe and Singapore much stronger. We will do some announcement later in next 2-3 weeks about that. But thank you all of you also pushing so heavily, proving that sky is not the limit. You can be every time successful. You can break all the models. You can break whatever things. And ignore people who tell you, no, you can't. No, it's impossible. And everything regarding that. So my biggest, like, thank you for all of you who worked so hard, motivated us, helped each other, and helped to bring this community feeling to so many people. Thank you. Salto Camp number 4 is officially done now. Woo! That's it. Time for party now. Woo! We have music. Maybe.
We have a lot. last thing to add, basically. The thing that you still don't know is that Peace Data would never happen if a few years ago,
five years ago,
Roman accepted the offer to be the CTO for Restream.
No, just developer not for CTO, the Restream. Developer. Yeah.
But he chose to create the own startups, and that's how we came.
Yeah, I think that Alex has very good taste of the people. So I trust Alex, but I also trust you. Thank you, Roman and Stacy. Thank you, everybody. We are now adding music. Let's party. Now is the weekend. Let's have a rest at least a little bit. Bye-bye.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.